Hello, it's Derek here. For the last couple of years, I was often being asked to bring Revit model into the Unity editor and make interaction with the architecture model, such as putting it into a VR headset. Although it doesn't sound too complicated, in fact, it can be quite time consuming depending on the model that I'm getting. To understand why this is the case, we need to understand the basic concept of rendering 3D models. All 3D models are constructed by triangles. Take a simple cube for example. One side of a cube is a square, and in order to construct a square, in 3D modeling world, we need two triangles. As you can see, even for a simple cube, we need to have 12 triangles, also known as 12 triangle counts. So, in a high-end architecture model, we can have up to millions of triangles, and all that triangles need to be rendered by your GPU. And if the application is in VR headset, it will even need higher GPU power to handle all the triangles. When the triangle count is much higher than your GPU can handle, the frame rate will drop. It will give user an unpleasant user experience, which usually causes motion sickness. We are just talking about triangles here, which we haven't yet mentioned about material, texture size, etc., which also use GPU to process. If the model is not complex, you can export the Revit model directly from Revit using File, Export, and select FBX format. This will export the model directly without further processing. And when I put it into 3D Max Studio, it gives us around 409,000 triangle counts. If you want to lower the triangle count, there are a few ways that you can do this. A common tool that I use to optimize the model is to use 3D Max Studio, then exporting it into FBX. I recently found out that in 3D Max 2022, you can directly import a Revit file, which previously the only way to do this is by exporting the Revit model into FBX and importing the FBX into 3D Max. Also, this new feature gives us the ability to give further processing to optimize the model. If we max out everything to give us the most optimized model, and it will give us around 334,000 triangles. However, if we zoom in to look closer, we can see that some parts of the model are broken because of the optimization. Now, since we max out everything in the settings, this is understandable. So if you want to use this method, it is totally okay. You just need to spend time adjusting the best settings for your use. The only downside is that FBX doesn't contain any beam data. If you want to create a 5-3 experience and with the ability to show some beam data from the model, you will have to manually create the beam data within the editor. This can be very time consuming. In here, I'm going to talk about the two ways that can bring your beam data into the Unity editor. The first way is by using Unity VFlat Develop. By exporting the model using the VFlat plugin, you can re-import it into the editor by using the VFlat package. All the beam data are also downloaded along with the model. This process does not optimize the model or reduce a great amount of triangles. So be sure to use the section box or the hide element feature before exporting when using VFlat. The other tool that I will use is Pipsy. Pipsy is a data preparation tool specifically for a wide range of CAD data. For more information on what type of file it supports, click on this link at the top right corner, and I'll also leave the link in the description below. So you can either use the Pipsy plugin for Unity to import the Revit model, or you can prepare the Revit file using Pipsy Studio or Pipsy Scenario Processor to generate the .pxz file format and load the data into the Unity. Either way, we give you all the beam data within the model, and it has the ability to allow you to optimize the model too. Although it is possible to get even lower triangle counts with 3D Max Studio, however, using Pipsy can let you pick which object to have a lower triangle count and also let you have the beam data. So, in summary, here is what you can use. If you want to bring your Revit model into the Unity editor and you don't care about the beam data, you can always use 3D Max Studio to give you the FBX output, On the other hand, Pipsy is probably the most powerful data preparation tool you can have right now, and it lets you keep all the BIM data too. Let me know what you think and feel free to leave me a comment, and I hope I will see you soon. Bye bye.